Hey, happy Friday, everybody. Mark again here at Weatherman. Plus, I got some good news for some people, bad news for other people. What's going to happen with this Invest 97L, this tropical storm potential hurricane Debby that's going to be forming. Now, you can see the latest information this morning. A lot of these models, just about all of them, the track guidance is taking it right over Florida. So it's taking that fast track and literally will be going over you by Sunday. But then it's going to get even worse along the coast. Now you can see this when you look at the precipitation just for the next 5 days. It gets really heavy for northern Florida, all of Florida getting in on this, but showing that it will go right over Cuba. This is the big change. This is going right north of Cuba, so it'll come off Hispaniola a little bit northern. It's not taking that wide track. You see how small this cone is. Matter of fact, I expect this cone to stretch right along the coast of the Carolinas also. Come showing a re-strengthening, just like we've been seeing, that it could get a stall effect. It could re-strengthen again, and that is all happening over here by the Carolinas. So I'm going to show you the latest information as well as a trend so you can see what's going on, because you do see the rainfall is adding up right along the coast of the Carolinas and Georgia as well. And all that orange is going anywhere from 5 to 7 inches, maybe even all the way up towards 10 inches, where you've seen all this brown right on the coast by Tampa. So I'm going to show you the latest information so you know what to expect. Thank you so much, everybody, for help alerting everybody, hitting the likes on the video, sharing the information, letting people know exactly what is coming around the corner. Now, if you've never been here before, make sure you subscribe. I am all year along with my weather forecasting. Make sure you click that bell so you do get all the updates. And the update this afternoon, I will again update you on what's going on, not only with this system, but the next wave that is coming behind this. So you do stay ahead of the tropics. Latest update from National Hurricane Center shows it is at 90% in the next 7 days, 60% in the next 48 hours, and they will have a NOAA Hurricane Hunter aircraft is scheduled to investigate this system later on today to make sure that we know exactly the strength and the potential path of this. Now here's a piece of information you can see from National Hurricane Center in 48 hours, showing it'd be right there off the coast of southern Florida, and that could be bringing tornado threats. Remember that, I will update you this afternoon. And as you go 72 hours, look how it takes that path right across from Tampa over towards Jacksonville. That would bring all of the rain and impacts would be on the southern side of Florida. Now, some of these are showing that this thing could easily get pulled a little bit further to the north before it goes across, and that would bring even more impacts into Georgia and northern Florida. So it's still not all the way panned out, but we're starting to see a little bit better what's happening with this tropical wave. Now we see the latest with the European. You can see as it moves into Saturday for tomorrow, that trough does come down deeper and pull this system quickly to the north. Then it gets pushed out by the high pressure and it gets pushed out to the east. Now this is where everything gets a little shady. When you go from 4 days to 5 days, it could either get a stall effect, it could go back to the west, it could go right up the coast, or it could just sit there and just strengthen. The Euro takes it as a little bit of a stall for a day, then takes it right up the coast with that system and very close to the coast. Best case scenario, it does not form in anything and just brings y'all rainfall. And just on that scenario, your rainfall amount is very heavy. But you can see it is trending with multiple ensembles, if not all of them. So you can see right here on your latest track guidance that it shows in 72 hours will be right here off the coast of Tampa. That would be east side impacts, chances for tornadoes as well. And going right across and in 5 days, either be on land or right offshore. So it's still going to be right here. And we still don't know if it's going to be on land or offshore. I'm still showing a potential stall right there. And as it moves out past 5 days. Now, when you look at the other track guidance, you can see it is showing the same thing. Right inland, right offshore, but maybe going right up the coast. And see that zigzag? That's that stall right there. And look at this one, another one showing it could go inland a little bit more, then come out and then get that stall right there. So we're still seeing a stall. We're still seeing another re-strengthening right after Florida. And even though Florida is getting this very heavy rainfall, this is pretty much going to be your best case scenario, is this very bad flooding you're getting. Latest intensity guidance shows that it maybe will get up to a strong tropical storm and maybe a low-grade hurricane. But pretty much they're saying that a hurricane is off the table. This is going to go over land interaction not only for Cuba, but for Florida also. Keep it somewhat on the weak side. Now, Euro is showing that some dry air could get in on this system, and the H-Wharf model, the hurricane model, is showing it won't. It would be robust enough to fight that dry air. But showing right before landfall on Florida, less than 72 hours, could be a strong tropical storm, and then stay weak and stay a tropical storm all the way for you, then as it goes along the coast of the Carolinas. And that's where it's predicted to strengthen up some, so I know this will change. So now when you look with the hurricane model, the H-Wharf, you can see that it does go right up the coast, but it still strengthens right up. This is the warmest waters right here. Some places are reaching low 90s and stays a tropical storm as it goes over Florida the whole time and then goes by the Carolinas. And this is where it gets that blocking pattern. Now you're going all the way till Tuesday and you get that stall effect. It sits there for a couple days and starts making that westward track all over again. Remember that double tap we saw in Florida? That's still a possibility. But you can also see with the H-Wharf that all that dry air, as it crosses over Florida, goes all the way down to a 989. As it goes across Florida, the dry air goes around it. It tries to get in the center a little bit, and you see how it just fights that off, and it just stays nice and strong the whole time. Then it's going to go back to the west potentially after that. Showing is going to be a big flood event no matter what, according to every single model run there is out there. So with the H-Wharf showing all that heavy rainfall, all that brown is going anywhere from 5 to 7 inches. Once you get in this white area here, that starts going towards 9 and 10 inches. But once you get towards that purple, this is where it starts going from 12 inches to 18 inches of flooding, and we're talking about within a few days. But you see how it's still not in stone yet. So when you look at with that hurricane model, the hurricane analysis forecast system A, remember we can only look at these when we have an invest, and it shows a little bit further offshore. That'll give it more chance to strengthen up, and not with the land interaction. Still agreeing it will get pulled by that trough, expanded high pressure. Still agreeing it'll be a 989 as you go through Monday. So this is a little bit slower. Remember, if it don't make it across by Sunday all the way into Monday, after that is when we have that potential for it to go back to the west after Monday. Showing it'll be all the way till Monday instead of Sunday crossing over Florida. And look how it strengthens right back up after it gets on the other side. Now we're going into Wednesday. This is definitely going to be a block if this was to show true, and it won't go up the coast. More likely it will come right back. Still showing that it is going to be a huge no matter what, even with the winds, even with the re-strengthening, the potential coming back. No matter what, it's going to be this big flooding event that you definitely need to get prepared for at least. Remember, all that white is going towards 10 inches of rainfall. And once you get to that purple, you start reaching 12 inches and above. So it's starting to show for northern Florida getting the worst. All of Florida getting rainfall. Georgia and South Carolina showing a big, heavy hot spot. Now, when you go by the hurricane analysis forecast system B, it shows also that that will widen up and it won't ride right up the coast. That is actually trending with the hurricane models, that it will be a little bit wider. And on this one, it takes it a little bit further to the Florida panhandle. It's not getting pulled by that trough. And it just weakens down over landfall. But now here we are again on Wednesday doing a stall effect. This is where it could last here for a few days. So whether it goes out or does that stall is not set in stone yet. Even though we're seeing some good news or some better news this morning, it's not good news for a lot of other people that had better news showing this thing was going to leave. That stall effect could be really bad. But showing the same thing as Hurricane Model A, bringing a lot of heavier rainfall towards northern Florida, Georgia, and South Carolina. Once again, all that brown is all 7-8 inches. All that white is going towards 10 inches. And that purple, 12 inches and more. Now, all this red over here for southern and central Florida, that is still anywhere from 3 to 5 inches of rainfall coming just in a matter of a couple of days. So regardless, it is going to be a flooding event. What I'm trying to figure out is if this is going to be just a one-time flooding event or is it going to be a double tap? So when we pull out the icon model, the same one that helped out with Beryl, you can see it is showing it is going to be a little bit wider, but it's going to be very weak because maybe some dry air getting a little bit into it. That's not trending a whole lot. What's trending is maybe some land interaction, but you can see it starts intensifying after it goes by Florida. And that's where it becomes an issue for the Carolinas because it starts intensifying after that. And Icon actually brings somewhat of a best case scenario. Not only that it intensifies and becomes worse for other people, but look right here for Florida showing northern Florida, southern Georgia. Heavy rainfall, but nothing compared to what we're seeing everywhere else. This is just another scenario. But you can see here, it's still everywhere. So according to the Icon, just for the next 5 days, this could last even longer. You can see how it brings heavy rainfall towards northern Florida, southern Georgia, and right along the coast of the Carolinas. That's with the Icon. When you look with the 5 days with the Euro, it takes it a little bit lighter, takes it quicker going out towards the Carolinas, but it shows that stall effect, and it's going to last even longer and go all the way up the coast with that. Now, when you look with the GFS, trying to get a trend, it's very hard, but it is trending that it could be something very weak at first and be worse for the Carolinas, and it could potentially add up and maybe go out. So we still have multiple scenarios, but the trend so far is showing that it will be closer towards Florida or get closer eventually towards Florida, go over northern Florida, so central and southern Florida would see the worst of the impacts. But then it'll go right by the Carolinas and start strengthening again. Now, whether it goes out or stalls or goes back to the west, we still don't know that part yet. We can only take one portion at a time. Because the Euro model takes it where it's very weak, not only land interaction from Cuba, land interaction from Florida, and it shows the weakest out of every single model out there. But agrees that it will start strengthening back up once it crosses over Florida by the Carolinas, but then takes it inland and curves it around the northeast after that. Showing something very weak right now. But best case scenario, this is just bringing a horrible flooding even further up the coast. But the Euro is showing that dry air will get involved, and that is why it keeps it so weak as it's going across Florida, as it goes by the Carolinas, still showing dry air will be inside of that coming from that trough and just keeps it weak. Now that is not the trend, definitely is not the forecast. I just want to show you what the Euro model showed because it was the only one that showed this path in the beginning. Still showing if from that case scenario, one of the best case scenarios, it will bring a lot of heavy flooding towards Florida. Nothing like what we're seeing on all the other models and maybe towards the Carolinas getting the worst part of it. But look at all the heavy rainfall going all the way to the northeast as well. But when you look for a trend, look at GFS. GFS is almost showing the same thing as the Euro now, showing it strengthening right offshore, but it's the only one that shows it won't get that long of a stall and it'll eventually get pushed out. So we will see, because anything past 72 hours, 4 days, still is unknown, because a lot of them is showing it could stall, it could go back, it could stall and go north. Still unknown at this fact. And the rainfall with GFS is almost showing what the Euro is showing. Now keep in mind, these are not high resolution models. The hurricane models are high resolution models, and this is the only time we get to see them. And they're seeing a lot more precipitation, a lot more rainfall, and they're seeing an intensification. So I will update you this afternoon so we can see what the next trend is. This is just what we had for this morning. So trying to bring you some hard evidence of what's going on with the system is still a little bit all over the place. We only see a little bit of it. This is with Weather Prediction Center, the meteorologists over there, showing that it will be anywhere from 5 to 7 inches in all of this orange, from southern Florida to northern Florida, all up Georgia and the Carolina coast. Then you got this big brown section right here, and that's going anywhere from 7 to 10, and the heaviest being right over here offshore of the Carolinas. So this shows that stall right there, adding up all that precipitation, and could go up the coast with anywhere from 2 to 4 inches of rainfall also. Now remember, this is not set in stone yet. The center could be on the right side of this path, bringing the impacts over here, and it could be all the way still on the west side of this path and start curving back like we've seen in the hurricane models, and that would change the impacts and the trajectory of this system. So I will update you this afternoon, that way you know exactly what is going on. Thank you so much for your time, everybody. Hope you have a very great Friday out there, and I appreciate every single one of y'all. Florida, this is no joke. You need to go out there and get some kind of material starting today before things change of the opportunity to get these materials. Just materials, just preparing for flooding. I don't think you need to put on your shutters, all on the windows, any of that going on. You need sandbags. You need to prepare for some heavy flooding. That is the least of what you have coming your way. You can see it right here for the amount of rainfall coming your way. You do need to prepare for flooding. Now, the Carolinas and Georgia, I would say the same thing for you, but there's a chance this could go offshore and all that precipitation could get missed a little bit. I'll show you the later afternoon update and we'll see if this is still trending, but definitely Florida, you need to prepare for some flooding. You need to get materials today. Psalm 77, verse 1. I cried unto God with my voice, even unto God with my voice, and he gave ear unto me. Amen. None of us are worthy for God to even look into our direction. For him to have mercy and for us to be living every single day by his grace is just a miracle in itself. Thank you, Lord, for weakening the storm. Please get this storm out of here. We do not want to see a tropical storm, a hurricane, anything like that forming up. And we definitely don't want this coming right back on land after it does its initial damage the first time. Please get rid of this storm. Still, your will be done, Father, not our will. And remember, all glory does go to God, our Father in heaven, Yahweh. And I always hope he keeps you safe every single day of your life and forever. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Happy Friday, everybody. Get ready for this flooding. That is our best case scenario, believe it or not. It's starting to look a little bit better, but it's not set in stone yet. Please get ready for some flooding. Georgia, Southern Georgia, Carolinas, y'all should think about this as well.